Thank you. this one now. Mountains that whisper the eventless same shout. I may make you feel, but it kind of make you think. Your sperm's in the gutter, your love's in the sink. So you run yourselves over the fields, and you make all your animal deals, and your wise men don't know how it feels to be sick. And the sandcastle itches are all swept away. In the tide of destruction, the moral malaise. The elastic retreat brings the curtains of play. As the last wave uncovers, send you back the boy. But you choose the world and the heels, and your sometimes rapidly feel, and your wise men don't know how it feels to be thick. Love that I feel is so far away. I'm a bad dream and I just can't. And you shake your head, yes, you said it's a shame. Yeah. door and the finger, no allowance but the others. The failing light illuminates the mercenary's grave. The home fire burning, the kettle almost boiling, but the master of the house is far away. The horse is empty, and warm breath cloudy in the sharp and frosty morning of the day. And the poor puts his pen by the soda sits his son. And the doctors of the family is moving with the prodigy, building castles by the sea. It brings a tidy tide to watch the father's side. Thank you.
Now we speak to Martin in a rather stunning beginning, which you'll probably hardly hear. It's very quiet. Actually, an interesting story about Martin. Martin has been unfortunately blessed with only a very small tool, a very small specimen of his wood. However, he did succeed in pulling this rather aged lady one night at a party and promptly took her upstairs to his bedroom. Her bedroom, sorry. Leaving the door slightly ajar so the rest of us could wait it outside with our cameras and everything. Very interesting photography, yes. Anyway, Martin stripped off all his clothes, naked, round, plump and pink, he was. Like a randy cherub. Very well stood there, completely new, with this very small specimen. The lady looked in horror and said, "Good God, who do you think you're going to satisfy with that?" Martin said, "The great aplomb, me, madam." Still doing the stretching exercises that I told you about? My God, my God.
Become one and we're done.
Something a little bit different, but very sensible and to a degree. This was the result, you understand, of a purely chance meeting between Jeffrey, while now searching for schoolgirls under the age of 12, and this splendid specimen of Darkwood, whose name turned out to be, after some investigation, Brian. Now, Brian is one of those old-time musical dogs, steeped in vaudeville and old-time entertainment. Has formed together specially for tonight a wonderful act of ventriloquism. Quism, what a lovely word. A thin blonde hair stood erect on his quism as the Admiral's wife stood to him. No, I didn't say that. Ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, herewith now forth with immediately Jeffrey Hammond and Brian, shall we?
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. First of all, I'd just like to introduce myself and my friend. This is Jeffrey Hammond, and my name is Brian. Okay, so here we go with a lovely little ditty. A one, two, three,
four.
How much is that dog in Wingo? How much is that dog in Wingo? I do hope that dog is full. How much is that dog in the The one with the water leaking. How much is that dog in the I do hope that dog is missing.
Martin, you're never going to play them, are you? He's got guts, hasn't he, standing there in that silly suit. Instead of wearing sensible protective clothing like yours truly. Probably wondering what I have under here. Actually, it's very painful. I've had it on for almost an hour already. It's rather hurt. It's very painful if you wear it too long. And I wear it about this long. No, honestly, boy. You didn't stand the chance, son. If your pants were undone, 'cause you were brave, the humanity. The society, when we wake up in the present day, a million generations removed from expectations of being who you really want to be. Thank you.
across the circle line, when the eyes won't leave behind. You have it on the run. And the silver spring of fire, you've got it on your eye. Shining in the setting sun. Do you ever get the feeling that the story is too damn weak in the heavens? Yes. All that everybody's on the stage, and it seems like you're the person sitting in the audience. Skating away, skating away, skating away, under the eyes of me.
This is a song from the album McQuaylung. Particularly quiet and sensitive piece, if you know what I mean. No, it really is, honestly. It's, featuring Jeffrey with another one of his splendid striped acquisitions. Let's have a look at this one, Wally. We call him Wally for short, but not for long. There he is! Oh, it's nice. Jeffrey's so mean, you know. So mean. He's one of the most tight-ass persons I've ever met. In fact, he's got such a tight ass, he uses a polo mint for a toilet seat. All good humor. Let's just go wandering aloud, is it?
Last night at the sunset, my heart in the rain. We are the saviors as we start over the fights between us. Thank you.
I should really introduce them to you, or you today. Them, us, we from it too. Who they? Reading from left to right, as we're accustomed to do in these civilized Western lands. Miss Liz, look, there she is, smiling away. Yes, lovely pair. And sitting next to Liz, there's Helen, Four Eyes Helen, with her radiant rays. John, stop that incessant row. John, shut up. Sorry, Rita. Big Mama Rita, sitting there. Look. Right, fellas. Hello, my dear. Go on, Rita, take your pick. Have your way with them. Don't even try it, lad. You'll never come out alive. And sitting next to Rita, standing in once more, deputizing once again for Princess Anne, good old Kathy, sister of Linda Lovelace, star of Deep Throat, and Kathy's very modest. She has a lot of talents. Two whopping Britons. Martin and I are just going to tune up for a second. We'll be right back. If it takes us too long, just amuse yourself by some Mars bars and contraceptive devices in the foyer way. I didn't say that. Writhing your bloody great buttocks around on that great small white stool. It's really off-putting, Bear. We call him Bear for reasons unknown. Even if they were, they'd be best left unsaid. One, two, three.
All looking for a street.
Thank you.
Ball in the carnival.
with the same old way. It's the same old story. Look how we balance the world on the tip of our nose, like sheep with a ball to the carnival.
That's all. Salvation.
Chanel of those, the cover of the tea. I put up my friend and to start away. You brought someone who's seen you down here.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. We're playing a song. Play a combination of two or three pieces by way of the bomb and farewell once again. Actually, before we do, however, we will introduce you to... I'll introduce you to the small, red, midget drummer we have in the back. This is Barrymore Barlow. And fresh from University Challenge. If you believe it. None other than Maestro of the Grand Piano Forte, Hammond Organ, and killed etc. etc. Mr. John Edmonds. He just to show that he's as fit as he ever was 2 years ago when everyone we were last in town has now gone from all a triple frontward somersault. A mild but nonetheless enthusiastic demonstration of gymnastic expertise. People will agree. Bullshit, yes, the quality. John Evans, here we go. Love it. The bomber. Newcastle Brown, that's what he means. Yeah. Okay, we'll see you later. You know I'm going for a drink after this show.
Oh,
problem.
Every Saturday morning, they have the peddlers loose. They got some gravel and met some food. Some grand tortillas. And the next time the die is cast, you promise it's a thank you.
Oh,